Good morning. It is 9 a.m. and we're at Green Park walking over to Buckingham Palace because we're gonna go and look at the state rooms there. I looked online and I think I'm not allowed to film inside the state rooms, so we'll see. But we're kind of early. We're meeting with two of my friends from my course to go inside. But we're kind of early, so I guess we can kind of have a look around the outside of the palace first. The weather's so nice compared to 2 days ago when it was raining, right?
Yes.
훨씬 편하지?
Yes.
Never seen it so empty. Never been here so early, I guess. How to get tickets for Buckingham Palace now. So every summer the Queen goes to her holiday home in Scotland, so Buckingham Palace is open. This year it opened July 22nd and it closes October 1st, 2017. So you can buy tickets. You just go to the Royal Collection Trust's website. I'm going to link the direct link to the tickets down below, but you just select your date and the time that you want to visit. All of the available times will pop up and it's a timed entry. So it's £21 for students and £23 for adults. And they had some other prices on there, but you can just see it on the website. And in terms of actually getting there, if you're facing Buckingham Palace, so like if I'm Buckingham Palace like this, then it's on your left side. Beneath these big trees. If you're in London between now and October 1st, I would really recommend you going because it's not every day that you can go into an actual working palace. These are the rooms where the Queen actually meets diplomats from all over the world and has her meetings there and dinner parties. And I found it more impressive. I found Buckingham Palace more impressive than the Palace of Versailles for that reason, because Versailles is basically a museum and something are still being refurbished and everything looks a bit outdated, but this one is in pristine condition and you can just imagine like Barack Obama walking down the halls to meet the Queen and things like that. So it was really cool. Like I said, you can't take pictures inside, but I was just so taken away by the chandeliers and the artwork and furniture and everything like that. And there's also a free audio guide that's included, so I was too busy with all of that to even think about taking the pictures. I think every summer they do a different special exhibition throughout the state rooms. So this year it was called Royal Gifts and they displayed all these different gifts that the Queen has received throughout her like 60 plus year reign from her visits to countries around the world. You kind of learn about different cultures that way because the gifts would kind of showcase that. And there was also a small exhibit honoring Princess Diana because this year is the 20th anniversary of her death, so they brought over her desk that she used at Kensington Palace, and her sons actually picked out some of the items to display just to reflect her life and things like that. That was also a nice touch to see in addition to all of the rooms. Anyway, the link is in the description box. I really recommend you go because it only happens for a couple of months once a year, so really take advantage if you can. And now we're gonna get ready to watch Les Mis.